Park Boulevard
and being married two or three times when your first spouse is still alive. We're telling you today, men and brethren, the Lord is commanding all men everywhere to repent of all sin and unrighteousness. We're saying today the word of God goes on to say that we should not walk as Gentiles walk in the vanity of their mind, having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God. And thus they don't want their deeds to be reproved. And so it is in the world today, men and brethren. This is why the world can't hear us. Only he that is of God, I hear the word of God saying in 1 John, can hear us. We're saying who have believed our report today, men and brethren. And to whom have the arm of the Lord been revealed? To whom have God's plan of salvation been revealed in these last times? We're saying you have to love righteousness, men and brethren, to come this way. I heard the Lord say, into you in at the straight gate. This gate that truly leads to life, men and brethren, is very straight and is very narrow. And I heard the Lord saying only a few are going to be able to find this way. Because the Lord is not saying what the false prophets is saying. The Lord is not saying come as you are, like you're hearing in these false churches. God is not saying that, men and brethren. The Lord is saying you got to labor to enter into that straight gate. You can't come this way in sin, men and brethren. You can't come to Christ in fornication. You can't come to Christ in adultery. You can't come to Christ in homosexuality. You can't come to Christ hating your neighbor. You can't come to Christ in the works of the flesh, men and brethren. You got to put off, as we showed you in Ephesians chapter 4, that old man, that old creature that you were born with. And you got to labor, men and brethren, to be born again of the Spirit of God. The Word of God tells me, everyone that doeth evil, everyone that loves sin, they're going to hate the light of this gospel. They're going to hate this form of truth being spoken in these last days. And they're going to hate them that are declaring. But I hear the word of God saying, the Lord tells us not to be discouraged. Because the Lord says if they hate you, you know that they hated me before they hated you. The word of God says, everyone that doeth evil, he's going to hate the light. He's not going to want to come to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. But he that doeth truth will come to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest, that they are wrought in God. We're telling you today, men and brethren, you got to labor to understand the plan of God for your salvation in these last days. You got to humble yourself. And that's the problem in false religion today, men and brethren. I heard the Lord saying in the book of Romans chapter 10 that the flesh, they don't want to humble themselves to God and to his righteousness today. But the flesh want to go about trying to establish its own righteousness and don't want to submit to the righteousness of Jesus Christ. But that's the only way you're going to be able to be saved, men and brethren. That's the only way you're going to be able to meet God in peace. You're going to have to humble yourself
and submit yourself to Christ and to his righteousness. The word of God says, men and brethren, in St. John, chapter 1, the word of God declares, St. John chapter 1, and verses 10, the word of God says, he was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But to as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God. And this is what the Lord came to do, men and brethren. You need to understand this today. This is the accepted time, men and brethren. I hear the word of God saying in 2 Corinthians chapter 6, this is the accepted time. This is not yesterday. This is today, men and brethren. This is the accepted time and the day of salvation. And we're saying today, men and brethren, you got to labor to receive Christ in your life today. You got to labor to receive the Spirit of God in your life today. The scripture says, Christ has given us power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. We're telling you today, men and brethren.
Okay.
We're telling you today, men and brethren. We hope that you're hearing something that can enlighten your understanding to the will of God for your life today, men and brethren. We're saying you need to repent of your sins and receive Christ in your life. In Jesus' name, amen.